Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kopke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. In each one of these episodes, we go over another 3D modeling tool and we are on episode 27 and today we are going to talk about split. So I have an example of a Ford F-100 and we're going to use the split tool in order to separate the door. So let's jump into Cinema 4D and get started. You've seen this F-100 truck in past tutorials. One of these days, it's no longer going to be a work in progress and I'm going to finish it. But for right now, it's really handy to show how to use different 3D modeling tools. And what we need to do actually is to split this door from the rest of the truck, because eventually we'll want to be able to rig and animate this door to move on its own. So to be able to 3D model it separately from the rest of the truck makes sense at this point, and it's all one big mesh. If we open up our hotkeys with our U button, you'll see that we have an option called split under P. So you can use UP in order to split this. You'll also be able to right click on something and you'll see under our tools, and they organize them really nicely. So we have our adding tools, we have our removal type tools, we have tools for cut, and under our clone tools, we can also find split, and it also lists the hotkey right next to it. So it's in a few different places, but we'll want to split this. So you can use the hotkey UP or you can just click here. And once I do that, you'll see all of a sudden we have this new mesh here. If I turn on viewport solo, you'll be able to see that we have split apart our door from our mesh. However, if we click on our original model and then hit viewport solo, you'll see that the door actually looks like it's still a part of the truck, and it just does that automatically. So it splits it, but it splits that part off of the mesh separately. So if you still want this part of the mesh to be gone, you'll have to hit delete for it to be gone in order to have that and not have duplicates. So we have now this mesh here, and we have this mesh here all separate. And that can come in really handy because for something like a vehicle, it makes sense to start off 3D modeling it as one form because you want everything to line up nicely. You want the door to blend in with the rest of the body of the car, but eventually at some point, that door is going to need to be separate so that you can animate it. So it's just something good to be aware of while you are 3D modeling. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you did find this quick tip helpful, please stay tuned for future tutorials. I cover a new Cinema 4D tool each week. And I hope to see you again next week on Wednesday. So I'll see you then, and I hope you have a wonderful day.